As I mentioned in a previous video, or showed in my previous video, my goats, I do put my females in coats for the winter if the temperature gets much below, 20, 25. It seems to help a lot. I tend not to put my male goat in coats because, number one, he's so stinky, and number two, he gets a much heavier hair coat on him than these girls do. Plus, the girls are working a little harder. They're either in milk, like this one, or they're pregnant, like that one. So, I want them to make the most use of whatever calories they take in. And so, I want them to stay warm as easily as they can. These coats, I've tried two different kinds. I've purchased full blankets, and the fit isn't quite right. They're just cut differently. And I have a lot more trouble with the full blankets than I do these, which are actually dog coats. And this is the extra large. It's like a 32 inch. If you can find them bigger, as you can see, it's just a little short on her. If you can find them 36 inch, you'd probably be good with a full-size alpine type goat. They're from Dover Saddlery, which is online, D-O-V-E-R. And what I like about these coats is they have buckle adjustments, so they're really easy to fit, and a buckle in the front. See if I can get a picture of that. Right down under here, there's a buckle, and there's also a little bit of Velcro right here if you need a snugger fit, which I don't find to be true or necessary with the goats. Now, a word about Velcro. This is a full blanket that I used for quite a number of years on Marty here, and it was a great fit lengthwise, but it had Velcro. And at first I thought it was a really nice coat because it had this real thick belly band. And then it was adjustable because the Velcro went up and over her back. The problem with Velcro in a barn setting is it fills up with every kind of little piece of hay and hair, and pretty soon your Velcro barely works anymore. And you can try to scrape it out, but it just gets worn out, and then your goats don't, or your coats don't stay on. So, I don't like coats with Velcro for that reason. But I also like a coat, let me just undo this so I can show you, that is either waterproof or water resistant but breathable. Very important. You don't want a fabric that's going to get wet and just stay wet. So you want something that either repels the water or is waterproof. And then I like a lining, and kind of a plushy lining, because the more air pockets you have under there, the easier for the goat to stay warm. And if you want, if you have room, you can pile some straw underneath there, especially if your goat is wet and you're putting the coat on and she's still wet for whatever reason. Goats don't like to be wet, but put some straw, some dry straw under there, and then put your coat on, and that acts like really nice insulation. Also, if you're going to use coats on any animal, not just your goats, do check underneath there and see what their condition is now and then. Make sure they aren't getting too fat or too thin. So peek under there, because you really can't tell once the coats are on. Sorry about the background noise. They're having a good time today with a four-wheeler and sleds. I'm going to have to put this down and do that.
So once again, these are dog coats in the extra, extra large or 32-inch size. If you can find them 36, that would be all the better.
And they work pretty well. Stay away from Velcro.